चल रहा है क्या ये? चल रहा है क्या? आरंभ है प्रचंड बोले मस्तकों के झुंड। हाँ आ गया। हेलो एवरीवन, अ वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून, अ वेरी 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 गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू। अच्छा चल रहा है। वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू, हाउ आर यू ऑल? एवरी कैन सी मी एंड हियर मी क्लियरली? गुड आफ्टरनून, गुड आफ्टरनून, गुड आफ्टरनून। सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स यू माइट हैव विटनेस्ड अबाउट सॉलिड एंगल, यू माइट हैव हर्ड अबाउट सॉलिड एंगल एंड इंटेंसिटी ऑफ रेडिएशन। दे आर प्रीटी टफ टॉपिक्स टू डील विद, राइट? बट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू हैव ए विजुअलाइजेशन ऑफ दैट, एंड ऑल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू इंट्रोड्यूस शेप फैक्टर, ऑल राइट? एंड टुमारो ऑल्सो यू हैव अ क्लास। आप गुनगुना रहे हैं आज एक हो जाए, नहीं आज नहीं, लास्ट में, इन दी एंड। ओके, सो व्हाट आई वाज टेलिंग यू इज कि टुमारो ऑल्सो यू हैव अ क्लास, बट योर ऑफ विल बी ऑन फोर्थ, एंड फ्रॉम आफ्टरवर्ड्स फिफ्थ ऑनवर्ड्स विल रिज्यूम आवर क्लासेस। ओके, इज इट क्लियर? सो प्लीज शेयर द सेशन एवरीवन, शेयर दिस सेशन एवरीवन एज मच एज पॉसिबल। प्लीज डू शेयर इट। आई नो मैनी ऑफ यू हैव बीन are there in Diwali breaks and enjoying at your home, and you will visualize, you will just watch the sessions as per your convenience and everything. So a quick summary about our plan. What I am going to do is, first of all, yeah, cleaning house. So first of all, we are going to finish this up. We are going to start IC engines, REC, then IC engines. And about power plant, everything has been covered in a separate, playlist has been there in a separate crash course, and whose link I'll send to you. You watch it from there. So it will save our time, and I'll conduct some doubt clearing sessions on this channel itself of power plant, so that you will be able to do the questions. So everything will be fine then. Okay, you will come in proper transition of five subjects, namely thermo, RAC, power plant, heat transfer, IC engine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five subjects I'll teach you. Okay. I'll tell you which, what are the lectures up to which you have to study. ओके, ये मुझे पता नहीं है संदीप, दैट आई एम नॉट अवेयर ऑफ। यू कैन आस्क दीपराज सर अबाउट इट, राइट? दीपराज सर विल बेटर टेल यू। पावर प्लांट क्रैश कोर्स प्लेलिस्ट फ्रॉम यस्टरडे, दैट्स ग्रेट। आई होप यू आर एंजॉयिंग दैट वेंकट। नाउ सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन व्हाट ग्रीन हाउस इफेक्ट इज, व्हाट ग्रीन हाउस गैसेज आर, एंड हाउ that greenhouse effect is going to be governed by Wien's displacement law. So we have seen that already, yes or no? Don't worry, I'll do that accordingly. Chaliye, let's go. Now we are going to go with solid angle. Let us understand. Please pay attention now. Solid angle. Solid angle is something which we are going to study. Okay? But before understanding solid angle, okay, I'll talk to him about that. Okay, Sumit? So, solid angle, about solid angle. Let's discuss solid angle. So, in order to understand solid angle first, good afternoon, Jay. In order to understand solid angle, let's first understand what a plane angle is. Let us discuss what is a plane angle. Plane angle. We denote it with theta. Plane angle is something which we denote for with theta. And now what about this plane angle? This plane angle is always given for two dimensions, 2D. Am I right? We always give them for 2D. They are always given for 2D. Now, how do we define a plane angle? This is very crucial, and you have to pay entire attention. For example, let us say you have a pizza, right? That is almost circular. If you have a pizza that is almost circular, now if you have, if you are, let's say, how many friends? Let me say that you guys are some four friends. Oh, let's say that you guys are some n number of friends. Okay. So how are you going to distribute that pizza amongst yourselves? You are going to do it like this, right? You are going to do it like this. Definitely. Am I right? You are going to do it like this. Okay? Yes. So here you can see. Now, how many friends can eat from this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So 8 parts have been done already. Is it clear? So 8 parts are there. Now, how am I going to divide it into 8 parts? Am I going to, you know, take a thread, measure it along the circumference, spread it along, take the note of the reading of the length, and divide it into 8 subsequent parts? Am I going to do that? No, that's not feasible. So rather, what is feasible is to have this angle. Am I clear? This angle. So rather you divide the angles, that will be far more suitable. Yes or no? Rather, what you need to do, you need to divide the angles. That's what you need to do. If you are able to divide the angles, calm set. Yes or no? You can send your doubts via WhatsApp. You send your doubts via WhatsApp, I'll take it. But after I complete the syllabus, okay? Now, so this is it. This is pretty much it. Plane angle, 2D angle, how do we define it? Let us say it is theta. The radius is R. And this is your arc AB. Now you know that the length of the arc, length of the arc AB. How do we give the length of the arc? We use the formula angle equals arc upon radius. Am I clear? Angle equals to arc upon radius. That's how we deal with it. Angle equals arc upon radius. Is it clear? Angle equals to arc upon radius means theta equals to arc is AB and radius is R. Now let's say if R is unity. Alright. Let's suppose that we are considering R as unity. If R is unity, then what will happen? We'll see. Okay, Shubham, we'll see. If I'm going to complete what I have come to teach in my mind, up to what I have come to teach in my mind, if it is covered in 1.5 hours, we'll take it by then. But it will be minimum 1.5 hours. Okay? So yeah, if R is unity, then what happens? Theta equals AB. Exactly, you know. So what is AB now? What is theta now? A plane angle is the arc subtended. See, arc subtended by a circle of radius, circle of unity radius. Unity radius at the center. Am I clear? This is the center. Now at this center, this arc is subtending an angle. If the radius is unity, that is the plane angle. Okay? It is always given for 2D. It is always given for 2 dimensions. Okay? That is why its unit is radians. Have you ever thought why the unit, SI unit is radian? बिकॉज इट इज रिलेटेड टू दिस आर्क, है ना। फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड यू हैव एंगुलर वेलॉसिटी, वॉट इज एंगुलर वेलॉसिटी, रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ एंगल, एंगुलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट, यस और नो। इफ यू आर चेंजिंग रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ एंगुलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज योर एंगुलर वेलॉसिटी, द यूनिट इज रेडियन पर सेकेंड। सो रेडियन पर सेकेंड, रेडियन पर सेकेंड, रेडियन पर सेकेंड, दैट्स वॉट इट इज। इज इट क्लियर? दैट्स वाई एंगल इज हैविंग अ यूनिट ऑफ रेडियन, नॉट डिग्री। एस आई यूनिट इज रेडियन बिकॉज द डेफिनेशन इज सच। नाउ वील गो विद द एनालॉजी, सॉलिड एंगल इफ दैट इज फॉर टू डायमेंशन, दिस विल बी फॉर थ्री डायमेंशन, फॉर ए थ्री डायमेंशनल ऑब्जेक्ट, इट इज गिवन इन थ्री डायमेंशंस, यस और नो। हाउ डू वी डिफाइन इट? लेट अस सी, लेट अस मेक अ स्फीयर, 3D, दैट्स अ स्फीयर। ओके, लेट्स हैव अ स्फीयर, द स्फीयर इज लाइक दिस, यस और नो। दिस इज आर स्फीयर, एंड वॉट हैव वी डन अप टिल नाउ? वी हैव अप टिल नाउ स्टडीड दैट, ओके, इफ वी टेक दिस एंड मार्क इट, दिस बिकम द हॉरिजॉन्टल एक्सिस एंड दिस वन बिकम्स द वर्टिकल एक्सिस, इज इट नॉट? इज इट नॉट? यस ऑफ कोर्स। सो दिस वी हैव सीन दिस, इफ यू रिमेंबर वी हैव सीन दिस एनालिसिस समवेयर, प्लीज ट्राई एंड रिमेंबर, स्फेरिकल कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम, यस और नो? यू जस्ट टेक दैट पीस ऑफ केक आउट, यस और नो? यू जस्ट टेक दैट पीस ऑफ केक आउट, जस्ट टेक इट आउट, एंड इफ यू रिमेंबर वी हैव टेकन दिस सेगमेंट विच वॉज स्फेरिकल, यू रिमेंबर? प्लीज टेल मी। एंड द नेम वॉज ए बी सी एंड डी, इफ यू कैन रिकॉल, यस और नो? एंड दिस ए बी सी एंड डी, इट वॉज मेकिंग एन एंगल, वॉट एंगल वॉज दैट? इट वॉज मेकिंग एन एंगल, इट वॉज सबटेंडेड एट द सेंटर, प्लीज टेल मी यस और नो? इट इज सबटेंडेड एट द सेंटर लाइक दिस। दिस वन इज सबटेंडेड एट द सेंटर, राइट? दिस वन इज सबटेंडेड एट द सेंटर, प्लीज टेल मी। या थीटा एंड फाई एंगल्स वर देयर, यू रिमेंबर दिस? यू रिमेंबर दिस? ओके, सो लेट अस टेक दिस सरफेस आउट, दिस सरफेस इज समथिंग लाइक दिस, यस और नो? दिस सरफेस इज समथिंग लाइक दिस, ए बी सी एंड डी, दिस इज द सरफेस, यस और नो? एंड नीड नॉट गो इन टू द डेरिवेशन वंस अगेन, वी नो दैट दिस इज आर साइन थीटा डी फाई, हैव वी प्रूव्ड इट और नॉट? यस ऑफ कोर्स वी हैव, एंड वॉट इज दिस माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स? आर साइन थीटा डी फाई, एंड दिस वन इज आर डी थीटा, यू रिमेंबर दिस? आर डी थीटा, आर साइन थीटा डी फाई, इज इट क्लियर? सो दिस इज हैविंग एन ए डिफरेंशियल एरिया विच इज आर साइन थीटा डी फाई ओवर आर साइन थीटा डी, सॉरी, आर साइन थीटा डी फाई, द एरिया इज आर टाइम्स साइन थीटा डी फाई टाइम्स आर डी थीटा, एम आई क्लियर? दिस इज द वन। सो डी ए बिकम्स आर स्क्वेर्ड साइन ऑफ थीटा डी फाई, दैट इज आर एरिया, इज इट क्लियर? दैट इज द डिफरेंशियल एरिया ऑफ द स्ट्रिप, दैट इज द डिफरेंशियल एरिया ऑफ द स्ट्रिप, इज इट क्लियर? दैट इज द डिफरेंशियल एरिया ऑफ द स्ट्रिप, वी शुड कंसिडर इट, यस, वी शुड टेक इट इन टू कंसिडरेशन, दिस इज द डिफरेंशियल एरिया ऑफ द स्ट्रिप, सिंपल एज दैट, ओके? आर साइन थीटा डी फाई एंड आर डी थीटा, डी ए इक्वल्स टू आर स्क्वायर साइन थीटा डी थीटा डी फाई, दैट इज द वन। ऑल राइट, अप टिल नाउ एनी डाउट? प्लीज टेल मी एनी डाउट अप टिल नाउ? दिस इज द डिफरेंशियल एरिया। अरे बाबा, वी हैव डिराइव्ड इट ऑलरेडी, नो? दिस एलिमेंट वी हैव डिराइव्ड, दैट दिस आर्क विल बी आर साइन थीटा डी फाई, दिस आर्क विल बी आर डी थीटा, सो दिस एलिमेंट वी हैव डिराइव्ड ऑलरेडी, सो देर इज नो नीड टू गो इन टू द डेरिवेशन वंस मोर। आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग वट आई एम ट्राइंग टू टेल यू? सो वी हैव डिराइव्ड दिस, प्लीज टेक अ नोट ऑफ इट, आई मीन टेक द स्क्रीन शॉट एंड देन वी शैल मूव फॉरवर्ड। Have you guys taken the screenshot? Good. Not good. It's good. That's great. Now what? Now please pay attention. Please pay attention. You have to pay attention. We defined it, the plane angle, in terms of arc. So the solid angle is similar. But since it was a two-dimensional object, hence the arc was one only. And if we have a three-dimensional object, the arcs are two. So how do we define it? Solid angle. This is omega. So here d omega is defined as dA over r squared. dA is area of differential spherical element. Okay, what is r? Radius of sphere. Why? This is something like this. We can break it into arc 1 upon radius times arc second upon radius, because there are two arcs. Yes or no? There are two arcs. So in the end, arc 1 times arc 2 becomes product, which is the area. Okay? Let's substitute it. So d omega over here becomes, okay, let me define it first. If the radius of a sphere were unity, if the radius of the sphere were unity, then in that case, what would happen? In that case, if the radius were unity, then in that case, d omega equals to dA. If the radius were unity, then d omega would have been dA. Means, let's go with the definition. It is defined as the area subtended by a surface of a sphere at its center of unity radius. Or if the radius is unity. Okay? That is how we are going to define it for sure. So that, my dear students, is your d omega equals dA. So the definition is similar. Over here we had an arc subtending an angle. Over here we are having a surface of a sphere which is being subtended at the center. Right? Let me show you. Let me make it visual to you. Let me make it visual for you so that it becomes easy to visualize. Let's see. Right? So this entire surface is being projected at the center. Hence, it will be area.
Because if you project this at the center, if you project this at the center, this becomes the area, and this area is d omega because you are projecting it at the center. Understood? Now you are able to visualize as well. Great. Now d omega equals to r squared sine theta d phi over, this one is r squared. So I believe d omega now becomes sine of theta d of phi. Is it clear? Now if I want omega, I have to double integrate d omega. Yes or no? I have to go with double integration or surface integral of d omega. One and the same thing. Surface integration, how would we obtain surface? By double integrating it. Are you understanding? Yes or no? Please tell me. Are you able to understand this? Please tell me. Now let me teach you double integration in a lucid manner. For example, you have omega, and let's say for a hemisphere. Bacche, listen. Here I'll correlate hemispherical emissive power with respect to this, and also I'll connect the dots back to the very basics like 8th standard, 9th standard, 10th standard. Okay, just wait and watch and enjoy the show. So for a hemisphere, let me tell you, how do we make a hemisphere? If you want to create a hemisphere, this hemisphere is something like this. Is it not? Definitely yes. If we have this as hemisphere, then you should take into account that this is the, sorry, this one is the horizontal axis, and that there goes your vertical axis. Horizontal axis, vertical axis. So the vertical axis angle is maximum 0 to 90, means theta belongs to 0 and pi by 2. Yes or no? And what about phi? If you talk about phi, this phi can move 360 degree around. This base is circular, no? So it can revolve like this. Yes? So this entire angle is available, 0 to 2 pi. Pi and 2 pi. So phi belongs to 0 to 2 pi. Now let us just integrate it. Okay. Now if I want to obtain a hemispherical surface, in order to obtain a hemispherical surface, simply do that. Omega equals to, just calculate the solid angle for that. Dekhna dhyan se. D omega. Right? Yes or no? Now this will be D omega. Are you understanding? Yes or no? Please tell me. Are you understanding? Yes or no? Please tell me. Now if you want to obtain the surface, simply do what? Take the integration. So let's say this is 0 to 2 pi, that one is 0 to pi by 2. Okay, which means 0 to pi by 2 sine theta d phi. Is that clear? Is that clear? Now I'm going to just integrate it. Okay, I'm going to integrate it. Take it into account. चलें आगे बढ़ें. ओके, नाउ ओमेगा, हाउ डू वी इंटीग्रेट इट? सो First of all, let me integrate it in front of you. This is pi by 2. And that one is 0 to 2 pi. Sine theta d theta. So now many people are confused. Even if you have triple integration, there is no problem. Let me tell you. Even when you have triple integration, there is no problem at all. If you know how to solve. How to solve it? First take the one which is inside. Integral which is inside. That is corresponding to the outermost. Okay, so integrate it, phi, d phi, phi, so it is phi from 0 to 2 pi, that's great, and then we are left with this, 0 to pi by 2, sine theta, d theta, understood? So there goes 2 pi, 0 to pi by 2, sine theta, now you know what this comes, this becomes 1. Yes or no? This becomes 1. Let's check. Integrate it. Put the values. It comes out to be 1. Ye bhi batana padega kya? So omega turns out to be 2 pi. Now what's the beauty of this equation? Let me teach you. What's the beauty of this equation? Please pay attention. Solid angle is surface area per unit radius squared. Yes or no? So it means that omega equals to area upon radius squared. Please pay attention, there's a very beautiful concept coming out. Area omega r squared 2 pi r squared. Haven't you seen this formula from your 9, 10th, 8th standards? That the surface area of a hemisphere is always 2 pi r squared? Yes or no? That the surface area of a hemisphere is always 2 pi r squared. Is it clear? Very beautiful concept. Please tell me, is it clear? Very, very, very beautiful concept. Understood, everyone? That's the beauty of it. That's the beauty in the face of it. Concept is clear. I believe it is. Now you do homework for sphere. That is your homework. Now you have to check in case of a sphere. That is your homework, my dear students. And how would you do that? In order to do that, it is very simple now. Just change the limits. Theta belongs to, this is a sphere. Theta, 0 to pi. There'll be a change in theta, right? It'll be 0 to pi. And then phi will belong to 0 to 2 pi. This would be the range. Okay? This would be the range. Is it clear? Now you integrate it. You will get 4 pi. So it will be 4 pi r squared. Yes or no? So if you know what is solid angle, you can get, and you know how these theta and phi are changing, you can obtain the surface areas. That's another concept what we are obtaining from here. That's the beauty of it. Is it clear? Please tell me. Understood or not? Clear? Okay. Next is intensity of radiation. Intensity of radiation. Now please pay attention. This is very crucial. Now if I ask you what is intensity of radiation, okay, let me give you, teach you with the help of an example. This is, let's say, sun, and this is the earth. They are not to scale, of course. And this sun is emitting some radiation. And since it is a diffused body, it is emitting radiation equally in all directions. yes or no, equally in all of the directions. Is it clear? Like this. So equally in all of the directions, radiations are being emitted. Like this. Continuously. Understood? Continuously, the radiation is being emitted in each and every direction. Whenever you have learnt about the renewable sources of energy, solar is the major renewable source of energy. And whenever we talk about solar energy, we are always concerned with intensity of radiation which we are receiving. So what is intensity in its real form? Actually, intensity is how much is the earth receiving. So in all the directions, out of all the directions, we are concerned only with this one. Yes or no? Of course, there is some tilt and that, this, that, everything is there. So what are we concerned about? We are only concerned about the portion of energy which we are receiving. We don't have any concerns as to what Jupiter is receiving, right? We have nothing to do with that. That is not of our cause of concern, right? So, intensity, now you can get the clear-cut idea. Intensity of radiation is, intensity of radiation is the amount of radiation emitted per unit area. Of course, means we are talking about radiation flux in a particular direction. In a particular direction, which means that intensity is nothing but emissive power per unit area. Means watt per meter square steradian. Acha, I have not told you what SR is and its unit. Let me teach you. Unit is SR. What is SR? Steradian. So the angle of emissive power per unit solid angle. Because solid angle will give us, so what is in the direction which is being emitted? Okay, in any particular direction, how much energy is being emitted? So that is represented by solid angle. That is why we are taking it per unit solid angle. Understood, everyone? So the unit becomes watt per meter squared steradian. Is it clear? Is it clear? Please tell me. Is it clear? Bolo yaar. Huh? Concept is clear? No. Let us take the following case. So we are going to take up the following case. And what is that following case? We'll understand. I hope it is clear to all of you, right? Kindly take a screenshot and we'll move forward. Kindly take a screenshot and then we'll move forward. Okay. Steradian, yeah, that's the unit, name of the unit, steradian. Solid angle ke liye unit jo hai, that is the name of it, steradian. Shall we move forward? Huh? Let us take the following case, okay? Let's suppose that this is the surface which is emitting radiation. That's the surface which is emitting radiation. I want to study it. What would you do? यू शुड सिंपली पुट ए हेमिस्फीयर ओवर इट. Simply put a hemisphere over it. That will do the work. Yes or no? That will do the work. That's all. Simply. That should do the work. Now this surface is emitting radiation in every direction. Yes or no? And the area of this surface is dA. Area of the differential surface, which is emitting radiation. And what is it? It's a diffused body. Is it clear? Is it not? Of course it is a diffused body. Yes or no? Of course it is a diffused body. Now we are concerned with as to how much radiation are we getting in this direction. How much radiation are we getting in this direction? Yes or no? We want to know how much radiation are we getting in this direction. Total. So for that, what should we do? We should do this. Let us take a, small spherical element like this. Anna, the small spherical element is making an angle, solid angle, this much. Is it clear? That is of course upwards, slightly upwards, but yeah, you might get the idea that okay, we are taking a element and then we are having it. So now what does it tell? समझ में आ रहा है नहीं? What does it tell? It tells that dE per unit d omega, that is I, or dE equals I d omega. That's how we obtain. Now let me connect the dots for you, okay? And you will be, jumping in joy once you complete this derivation. So this dE now becomes I sine theta d phi. Yes or no? We know this solid angle with respect to this is sine d theta d phi. We have come to this. Okay. And let us just name it equation number one. Before continuing with this, let us study Lambert's cosine law first. So there is one more small rule or law which we should study before moving further, and that is known as Lambert's cosine law. And this is also very important. Okay, this is also very important. Now let's learn about Lambert's cosine law. For example, this is a surface which is emitting radiation. This is the surface, okay? And the surface is emitting radiation in the normal direction. All right? This surface is emitting radiation in the normal direction, let's say. This is IN. And also this is emitting radiation in I direction. Okay? And the angle made is theta. All right. So now what is I? I will be IN cos of theta. Simple. Is it clear? Now, How do we define it? Intensity of radiation in any direction is any direction is cosine of कौन सा एंगल था ये जेनिथ एंगल और वर्टिकल एंगल मेड बाय दैट एंगल मेड बाय दैट डायरेक्शन विद द नॉर्मल ऑफ द सरफेस of the surface okay is known as Lambert's cosine law that is it so substitute in equation number 1 let us substitute in equation number 1 if we are going to substitute in equation number 1 what are we going to get DE equals IN cos theta sin theta d theta d phi now what should we do simply multiply it and divide it by 2 okay if we do that our d becomes IN twice of sin theta cos theta d phi by 2 Now sine theta cos theta sine 2 theta. Yes or no? DE becomes I by 2 IN by 2 sine 2 theta d phi. That is the relation. Now if I want to do this, if I want to calculate E will be the integration of DE, surface integral or the double integration of DE. One will be for phi, other will be for theta. Is it clear? Because one is phi, the other one is theta. That's as simple as it can get. Please tell me. Say yes or no. Of course it can. Now let us just put it this way. E equals integral, double integral, IN. Sine 2 theta d phi that is from 0 to 2 pi and that is from 0 to pi by 2 hemispherical ab samajh mein aaya total hemispherical emissive power yes or no total hemispherical emissive power now if I want only in this much direction what I would do from 0 to let's say it is 50 degrees 0 to 50 degrees If I want to calculate in from 0 to 40 degrees, I will do only that. Feeling aaya? Now, if I am doing from 0 to pi by 2, that means I am calculating for the entire hemisphere. Hence, its name was total hemispherical emissive power. Dots connected? Please tell me. Now the dots have been connected. Simple as that. Is it clear, everyone? हां जी ओके सिंपल प्लीज टेल मी यार डोंट टेल मी दैट यू डिडंट एंजॉय दिस कनेक्टिंग द डॉट्स फ्रॉम वेयर वी स्टार्टेड वी हैव नाउ कम टू द कंक्लूजन एंड दिस फॉर्मूला व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू डिराइव इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड क्वेश्चंस कैन कम डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम दिस फॉर्मूला बिकॉज दिस फॉर्मूला इज इंपॉर्टेंट ओके गाइज प्लीज टेक अ नोट ऑफ इट Please take a note of it. Shall we? Okay. Now, before moving further, for a diffused body, don't you think IN विल बी डेफिनेटली इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ आई एन विल बी इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ व्हाट आई एन विल बी इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ थीटा एंड फाई एज वेल सो विल बी अल्टीमेटली इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ दैट विच मीन्स दैट ई विल बी नोन एज आई एन 0 to 2 pi and I n by 2 my mistake 0 to 2 pi sine 2 theta d phi 0 to pi by 2 I believe that E becomes now I n by 2 into 2 pi if I solve this pi 0 to 2 pi it comes 2 pi 0 to pi by 2 sine 2 theta d theta yes or no and if you solve it it'll come 1 yes or no so e now becomes simply pi times I n yes or no is it clear or simply I n is e by pi Intensity in normal direction. We can find it out like this. Now, if you have a black body. Now, if the body is a black body. Now, in case that we have a black body. So, in case of a black body, what would you do? If we have a black body, then it will be EB equals pi IN of the black body, INB. Yes or no? I n of the black body. Yes? Of course. If you have E lambda, that will be pi times I n lambda. If you have E B lambda, you have pi times I n B lambda. Of course, you are going to obtain these relations. Is it clear now? Is it clear now? That's how you are going to obtain them and I hope you are going to enjoy them. Is it clear? Tell me. Let's do a question. One part I'll do, the other part I'll give you as a homework. Okay? A surface with emissivity of 0.3 is at 1000 Kelvin temperature. Okay, find out number one intensity of radiation in normal direction. Okay, total emitted radiation from zero to 60 degrees zenith. Okay, let's do the solution. So I am telling you one part I am going to do. The other one you will do. Please check. आगे फेक आईडीज वेलकम फेक आईडी देखो यहां पे व्हाट इज एमिसिविटी 0.3 व्हाट इज द टेम्परेचर 1000 केल्विन है ना So, if you go with this, neend aa rahi hai, kuch bhi aa rahi hai, jaake so jao. Who called you? Huh? Nobody cares about you. You are so much into yourself. Pathetic. 1000 Kelvin, right? Let the others study. Okay? ब्लॉक करो भाई इसको, ये जो क्या है ये फेक आईडी, प्रदीप दालुई, ब्लॉक करो इसे। हाँ, सो वी हैव एमिसिविटी एज 0.3 एंड टेम्परेचर एज 1000 केल्विन, यस और नो? नाउ आईएन इज रिक्वायर्ड, नाउ वी नो दैट सिंस आईएन इज ई बाय पाई, हाउ डू वी कैलकुलेट ई? सो यू विल गो विद स्टीवन बोल्ट्जमैन लॉ, ऑल राइट? यू विल गो विद स्टीवन बोल्ट्जमैन लॉ। सो इफ वी गो विद स्टीवन बोल्ट्जमैन लॉ, हाउ डू वी सॉल्व इट? ई इज उप्सिलॉन सिग्मा टी टू द पावर 4, इज इट नॉट? यस, वी हैव स्टडीड, इनटू 5.67 10 टू द पावर -8 1000 टू द पावर 4 ओवर पाई, दैट विल बी योर आई एन। सो हाउ मच इज द वैल्यू ऑफ आई एन कमिंग आउट टू बी, प्लीज टेल मी, एंड द यूनिट लेट मी टेल यू विल बी वॉट्स पर मीटर स्क्वायर्ड स्टेरेडियन, एस आर स्टेरेडियन। इज इट क्लियर? इज इट क्लियर? अरे बोलो भाई, सही है सर? नो, नाउ लेट मी गिव यू द हिंट हाउ टू सॉल्व दिस। इन ऑर्डर टू सॉल्व दिस, कीप इट 0 to 2 पाई, बट इन प्लेस ऑफ दिस 0 to पाई बाय 2 यू विल कीप 0 to पाई बाय 3, राइट? 5414.45, 5415.45, दैट माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स इज योर आई एन। नाउ फॉर सेकेंड पार्ट यू नीड टू डू दिट्स एंड यू नो हाउ टू डू इट, ऑफकोर्स ई इक्वल्स टू 0 to पाई बाय 3, 60 इट इज, एंड 0 to 2 पाई ऑफकोर्स साइन ऑफ 2 थीटा डी थीटा, सॉल्व इट, यू विल गेट द आंसर इन टू आई एन, एंड आई एन यू हैव कैलकुलेटेड ऑलरेडी। इज इट क्लियर? आई एन यू हैव ऑलरेडी कैलकुलेटेड। कैन यू डू दैट? कैन यू डू दैट? इज इट सिंपल? इज इट सिंपल इनफ? से यस और नो? इज इट सिंपल इनफ? प्लीज टेल मी। इज इट सिंपल इनफ? हाँ जी, इजी पीजी हो गया, बस सर, डू इट फास्ट। टेकन द स्क्रीनशॉट, टेकन द स्क्रीनशॉट, ग्रेट। नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू शेप फैक्टर। द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक विच वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इज व्यू फैक्टर और शेप फैक्टर और कॉन्फिगरेशन फैक्टर और जियोमेट्रिक फैक्टर। दीज आर द नेम्स, कॉन्फिगरेशन फैक्टर, शेप फैक्टर, जियोमेट्रिक फैक्टर, व्यू फैक्टर। सो दीज आर वेरियस डिफरेंट नेम्स विच इट हैज। ओके, एक क्वेश्चन इस टॉपिक से पक्का। हाँ, इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। All right. So today I'll introduce it to you. We'll do the analysis and everything tomorrow. Tomorrow is going to be that. It will take time to be perfect in this. But let me tell you, a simple background of this. Let me give you a background of this. You have your cell phones, right? And if you have your cell phones, many people you have seen that they take selfie like this. They take selfie like this. And sometimes they take selfie like this. Yes or no? So they orient this cell phone in various different directions. Yes or no? In various different directions. They are orienting their cell phones. Is it clear? In various different directions, they are orienting their cell phones. And according to that, when they are doing this, they seem that they are very dwarf. Then when they do this, they seem like they are very tall. And this is when this height is same as the actual one. Yes or no? That's how different photographs come. So in the same way, view factor tells about how two objects view each other in the empty space. How they view each other. Okay? How they view each other. Next. It is purely a geometrical concept. There is no thermodynamics in this. Are you getting it? It is a purely geometrical concept. Yes or no? What is the meaning of geometric concept? Means totally independent of all the surface properties. What all are the surface properties? Tau, phi, yes or no? Tau, alpha, rho, epsilon. So it is independent of all the surface properties. Is it clear? It is purely a geometric concept. Means it is totally independent of all the surface properties. Like emissivity and temperature. That's what I have told you. How two objects are viewing each other. Viewing each other. Doop, 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 like this. Understood? Is it clear? Getting my point? Arey yaar, block karo na isko yaar. Block this person. Faltu disturb kar raha hai. Pushpendra, just block this person yaar. Simply block this person. Okay? Just a minute. It's some emergency. Father is calling. Just a minute. हाँ वो आया था बट अभी क्लास में मैं बोलो हाँ इमरजेंसी हाँ सो पुष्पेंद्र भाई पुष्पेंद्र भैया जस्ट ब्लॉक हिम यार दिस पर्सन इज कॉजिंग मी अ हेडेक है ना इफ वी डू नोट्स एंड राइट इन एग्जाम फॉर डेरिवेशन व्हाट विल वी गेट फुल मार्क्स अरे यार मैं नहीं दे रहा मैं नहीं बता रहा फुल मार्क्स दिस मार्क्स दैट मार्क्स इफ यू आर कमिंग यू आर स्टडिंग यू आर डूइंग द क्वेश्चंस यू विल गेट मार्क्स एंड एवरीबडी नोज दैट ओके सो इट इज प्योरली अ ज्योमेट्रिक कॉन्सेप्ट यस और नो एंड इट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ ऑल द सर्फेस प्रॉपर्टीज एंड टेम्परेचर एंड एवरीथिंग इज इट क्लियर यस और नो So, what I am trying to say is, let's say these are two objects and they are viewing each other. Let's say I am changing the orientation now. Let's say I am changing the orientation. Okay? There is one, there is two. There is one, there is two. Shape factor will change. The viewing will change. Of course. And if I change orientation and geometry, let's say this is one and I have made this one as two. So it means that shape factor depends upon the orientation and geometry of the objects. All right? Orientation and geometry of the objects. It is independent of that. It is dependent on that. Is it clear, everyone? Is it clear, everyone? So it is dependent on that. Because the view is changing. If you change the view, then, if you change the geometry, and if you change this orientation, the view is changing. So what happens if you change the view? Right? Why we are concerned? Why are we concerned with the view of one body with respect to another? View of one body with respect to another. Hai na? So much. Why are we concerned? Why are we concerned with this? Yes or no? Because let us say that this is surface 1 and this is surface 2. These are two surfaces, 1 and 2. Then definitely some energy is leaving this surface. Yes or no? And it is reaching the other one. Some portion will be going out in the space and the some portion will be coming in. Yes or no? Similarly, some portion is going out from this surface. In every direction it is being emitted. Like this. Is it clear? Are you understanding? So what happens in this? What happens in all of this? Both surface 1 and 2 are emitting radiation. They are emitting radiation. And for net radiation heat exchange, what is important? It is important to know the fractions of energy which are leaving one surface and reaching other one. Understood? something like that, Rishabh. Understood, everybody? Say yes or no. Is it clear? So that's why we do this. That's why we do this. Leaving one surface, reaching other one. And if you want to calculate how much is the net exchange. For example, I give you 100 rupees, you give me 1000 rupees. So there's a net exchange of 900 rupees. Understanding my point? That there's a net exchange of 900 rupees. That's how things work. Is it clear? Is it clear, everyone? That's pretty much it. So we'll continue the analysis tomorrow. I have some work and I have to leave in the emergency. I'm really sorry. There was a call of father and I cannot avoid that. Sir, can we say it's similar to projection of one surface? No, it's not similar because we are talking in terms of energy. We're not talking in terms of projection. Right? If you want to do the projection, then you want to bring one body over the other one. But it is not like that. Exactly. We are only concerned about the energy. How energy is being received at the other one when it is being emitted from the first one. That is how things are. Understanding, everyone? Please tell me. Say yes or no. Say yes or no, please tell me. Hanji? Okay? Take the screenshot. We'll continue tomorrow and we'll finish it up, radiation. Happy Dhanteras to all of you. And lots and lots of love from my side to each one of you. And may Lord Ganesh and may Lord Ganesh bring you all the mind and prosperity, and Lakshmi comes to your home and never goes out. Okay? Chalo. Just follow it from your from the beginning. That would be enough for your exam. More than enough. Chalo, okay. Bye-bye. Take care. Jai Hind. Love you all. Do take good care of yourselves. Kal class hogi. Parso nahi hogi. Parso will be an off. Kal hogi. Okay. Love you all.